Neighborhood to explore a little bit of the city, and we stopped at a place called Socalo, which is a public square with a lot of restaurants all around. There are vendors,
musicians.
Yeah,
as well.
It's really a bustling place, and we stopped to grab a little juice by the park. The juice there, they call it Copa Globo. This is actually the size of the glass. And it's so big and really cheap for the price. So we just had a little juice, just watched people walking by, the musicians. It was a really nice moment.
What did you order?
I don't remember. It's called Grosella. It's
una
limonada de grana.
This is $2.50.
That's crazy. So after a beautiful Copa Globo on the Zocalo Park, we started walking towards two markets that are actually right across the street from each other. So one is called Benito Juárez, where we can buy groceries and fruit and vegetables, and the other one is Mercado 20 de Noviembre, so November 20th, where there are more restaurants, and that's actually where we got our hot chocolate that's typical from Oaxaca. One thing I don't understand here is that the hot chocolate is served with bread, but it seems like they all do that.
Oaxaca is famous for its chocolate, and their hot chocolate is served with a lot of cinnamon. It's kind of spicy and sweet. It was really good, but the bread,
yeah.
We did not understand, but...
Is it supposed to be a full meal? I don't know.
To do on our first day in Oaxaca was go to a lavanderia because all of our clothes were dirty. So we stopped to a little place called Santa Maria, and it cost us around 60 pesos for our lunch. After all that walking, we got really hungry, so we stopped at Casa Taviche for lunch, which is a restaurant that serves Mexican food. We ordered squash soup and tlayudas, which are a typical food in Oaxaca. It's basically cheese, vegetables, and other filling in between tortillas, and then they grill both sides of the tortilla and cut it in kind of like pizza shape tortillas. So it was really, really good.
Yeah, and there's usually or red or green cabbage inside. All right, so first real activity in Oaxaca here. We're gonna get a tattoo. It's Bridget's first. We have a pretty good idea of what we want. It's about two blocks from here. But yeah, that's the plan for this afternoon. So yeah, stay tuned. We'll show you what the experience is for getting a tattoo in Oaxaca.
Hey guys, it's actually the next day because we realized we had to take a reservation. So it's 1 p.m. right now. Our appointment is like in 5 minutes.
Like
so
right now.
Yeah, like right now. So we'll head out and yeah.
Wish me luck.
First day when we went, we actually talked about what we wanted and sent him pictures of inspirations that we had.
The guy that tattooed us was really nice. We spoke in Spanish with him a little bit so we could understand each other pretty well. He was really calm, so I was really nervous. So I was glad that our tattoo guy was really laid back and relaxed. And I wanted to tattoo with really fine lines, so I was happy to see that he could do it with really, really nice fine lines, straight, and yeah, he was really good. We recommend him.
We're grabbing breakfast in a very small local restaurant, very cheap. We'll show you the menu in videos later. And then after that, we're gonna go do a workshop of black pottery, which is a typical pottery from Oaxaca and Mexico. The black pottery workshop was very interesting. It lasted 4 hours, so from 10 to 2 p.m., which was plenty of enough time to start over again, maybe 3 or 4 times. So we wanted to make bowls. Mine was a ramen bowl and hers was more like a cereal bowl. For the price, it was 150 pesos per person and 50 pesos more if one of the pieces baked.
Yeah, the baking process took about 1 week. So you have to be there for at least 1 week if you want to have your piece ready before you leave. For mine, I decided to do a little design around it. The professor helped me a lot because it was kind of difficult to do designs. But what I liked the most is that all of the designs were made with things he found in the trash, like caps of water bottles or things like pencils that he found in the trash. So it was nice to see how he created those beautiful designs on this site with just things that were free, basically. So yeah, we really liked the experience. So it's 1 week later and we have our pieces here of pottery. I'm gonna show you what it looks like. So this is our mine for now. I don't know if you can see, but I did some designs on the sides. During the baking, it actually broke. I don't know if you can see right here, but the guy had to repair them. But they still look pretty good, I think. Now we have a bowl that we can bring with us everywhere. This is how Matt's turned out. Matt's is a little bit more like a ramen bowl. Mine is a bit more shallow, but yeah, this is how they turned out. Hey guys, so we just realized that there's no outro for the video, so here it is. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe on the video. Also follow us on Facebook and Instagram if you want to see daily stories and watch us travel. See you soon.
Peace.